Hey guys, Mike here, one go short play, playing Atomic Robo-Kid on the Sega Mega Drive. Now, I recently took a chance on this. I saw it in a retro gaming shop by where I live. Just the cart, it was a Japanese cart, and I've got one of those, you know, honey thingy converters. And so I popped it in, had a go. It was like a couple of quid. And I loved it, I thought it was great, a great version. I think it feels a bit unfinished. Like there's no sound on the front end at all, and then suddenly you're in the game. Now, other than that, these slow you down. I think once getting started was a bit of a problem, and it was really hard work. But I think if I can get through that, if I can get through it, you'll see an awesome game as your reward. It's harsh at first, but I got through the first. It took ages getting through the first level, but when I did, I found that there was a brilliant game behind it all, with quite a lot of variety to it. And I'm going to just try and reproduce my experience of it, because it was months ago, maybe even a year or so ago that I bought it, and I had that awesome experience. Oh yeah, of course, you can shoot them and get different ones. Oh, no you don't. See, these first bits are just a bit tricky and tough. Now, this came out all over the place. I think it was like a PC Engine game, but it came out on pretty much everything, including like the ZX Spectrum, or it almost got released. I played the Amiga version, I think I played it on my channel, and it's full of bugs, it crashes like mad. And I remember it was always the case, trying to get any copy of that game to work on the Amiga, it would always crash like mad. This is the most, despite it being kind of unfinished, or feeling kind of unfinished, this was the most complete version of it I played, and it's good. And I kind of wish that I could have seen it on other versions. I think it was sort of a PC Engine game, and it was ported from that. I might be wrong, I'm always wrong about this stuff. Or am I? We'll find out when I put the video up here. But I'm generally wrong about stuff that I suppose, that I make suppositions about, or that I kind of make guesses to. I haven't done any research on it. It's just kind of information I've picked up over the years. What's the R do? Oh, repeat fire, rapid fire. Really like that. This might actually give me a chance of getting to this level. That's right, these nasty little things. Yeah, that rapid fire really helps. I don't want anything else. I've got rapid fire. Yes. I think that is the exit. It is! And yeah, this version was, oh man, that was just unfair. This, oh, I lost me rapid fire, man. Oh, really? Yeah, getting through these first bits. It's tricky. talk and play. Okay, so the PC Engine version, I think, was the proper version. And the support of that. I think, am I right about that? Am I wrong about that? Feel free to tell me. If YouTube tells me I've got comments, I will check them. It doesn't seem to tell me lately, so I just have to check as I remember to. And given that real life has lots of other things in it that, you know, generally take priority, it's not very often that I check. I remember this bit. It's just fancy, but really cool. If you can just keep your head. Oh yeah, that's quite useful, surely. I think. Yeah, it has a real variety of weapons. This game, that was a bit sly. It has a real variety of weapons, and as you can see already, the levels get quite varied too. And that can't be a bad thing, can it? It's an awesome game, it really is. I think it was a kind of an unsung game, because most of its ports were so crashy and buggy, and it was generally quite unloved. And maybe it fits that old adage that my boss always told me, never make games about robots, aliens or insects, which I also mentioned on my short play of Alien Soldier. I think Alien Soldier is possibly the exception to the rule. It's awesome, although again not particularly popular in its day amongst people who weren't avid gamers and didn't really know already what that game was about. Ouch. So maybe it is true. Atomic Robo-Kid is also an awesome game that didn't really get the respect that was due, I feel. Well, this version anyway, and possibly the PC Engine version. As I say, the Amiga version was a buggy wreck, and I think the Spectrum version, I don't think it ever came out. I'm not sure about that. I might be wrong with that. It might have been brilliant, the Spectrum version. Oh, you little swag! I remember it being pretty harsh. Not pretty harsh, pretty non-existent, or pretty unreleased. I'm sure there was a version of it made. I might be wrong. I usually am. These are nasty baddies. Oh, man. I think this continues. There are. Let's continue. I got quite far on this when I played it on the Mega Drive. Much further than this bit. But this is a particularly nasty bit, as you've probably noticed. I could really do the upward shooting shot. I mean, there are ways around all these bits. It's not without design, you know. It's just there, really, really harsh. Right, come on. No more talk. Play. No, let's not put that aside. Oh, yes. Awesome. Yeah, try shooting the big green ray now, yeah. Baddie. I've got to think of some insults that aren't swearing. Oh, no, really? Really? Oh, man. Okay, so we've got a series of checkpoints here. They're pretty hard to reach at the best of times. Oh, right in the back. Right. Oh, man. That was just silly. It is really, really harsh. But I actually enjoy this game a lot more than most side-scrolling shooters, and it's because I think we've got a character, and I like character-based games. I just like them. I grew up on Thundercats, for God's sake. Hey, look, some of those ones didn't respawn. That's kind of cool. I will take that. Yes, we get quick off the ball as well. Oh, look, they have respawned. Oh, they've all respawned. Oh, nasty. Checkpoint? No. Oh, we've got to do it all again. Okay. If I don't do it within this continue, I'm going to call it a day there, I think. Awesome game, though. I would really recommend it. I'm not going to over-egg the pudding by playing this bit over and over again for too long. But once you beat it, and I have beaten it before, there's so much more that this game's got to offer. It has these really cool one-on-one rounds where you take on another Robo-Kid. And it's like, I don't know if you ever played High Noon. I'm talking Spectrum games again. High Noon might be different on the arcade. Shootout, is it? The one with the cowboys, two cowboys going up and down the screen shooting each other. It's a bit like that, but with two Atomic Robo Kids. Oh, slightly different designs as well, which is dead cool. Oh, how close was that? And they're like level bosses, I guess. And they're really hard. Anyway, that's enough of that. Atomic Robo-Kid, Sega Mega Drive, really good game. Check it out if you can. Thanks for watching.